Ex-President Obama, I bet when I die you'll be happy to pee on my grave. This is a true story. General Stanley McChrystal was the commander of U.S. forces in Afghanistan and he had frequent disagreements on the conduct of the war with his commander-in-chief. At one point McChrystal was called into the Oval Office and he knew his army career was about to be over. When former U.S. military commander in Afghanistan, Stanley McChrystal, was called into the Oval Office by Barack Obama, he knew things weren't going to go well when the president accused him of not supporting him in his political role as president. "It's not my job to support you as a politician, Mr. President, it's my job to support you as commander-in-chief," McChrystal replied, and he handed Obama his resignation. Barack Obama has a long history of hating the U.S. military and men and women who serve. He is never one to let someone have the last word, but he failed in this instance. Good job, General McChrystal. I'm pretty sure that after 5 or 6 years of being in the ground, the line will have diminished enough so that you won't have to stand in line. You're an honorable man, we know you wouldn't cut in front of others. A Rolling Stone magazine profile of General Stanley McChrystal, commander of U.S. and NATO forces in Afghanistan, had generated massive controversy. General McChrystal and his staff are portrayed making unflattering comments about top U.S. officials, and he has been summoned to Washington in the wake of the article. He has apologized. The Rolling Stone article quotes General McChrystal saying he felt betrayed by the U.S. ambassador to Afghanistan, Carl Leckenberry, who last year argued against troop increases in a telegram to the White House that was leaked to the media. "I like Carl, I've known him for years, but they'd never said anything like that to us before. Here's one that covers his flank for the history books. Now if we fail, they can say I told you so." The full text of the Leckenberry telegram was leaked to the New York Times in January. It attacked General McChrystal's strategy and said President Hamid Karzai was not an adequate strategic partner. General McChrystal on Special Envoy Richard Holbrook. U.S. Envoy to Afghanistan and Pakistan Richard Holbrook is a veteran diplomat with whom the general would be expected to work closely. But the Rolling Stone article suggests that General McChrystal was dismissive when he received a message from Mr. Holbrook on his BlackBerry. "Oh, not another email from Holbrook. I don't even want to open it." General McChrystal had a special skepticism for Mr. Holbrook, the article suggested. General McChrystal on dinner with French officials. The Rolling Stone article starts with a vignette about the general reluctantly attending a dinner in Paris as part of a mission to persuade the French government to maintain its efforts in Afghanistan. "I'd rather have my ass kicked by a room full of people than go out to this dinner. Unfortunately, no one in this room could do it." The article quotes an aide of the general as saying the dinner is with some French minister. General McChrystal on Vice President Joe Biden. The magazine article depicts General McChrystal's staff discussing the prospect of being questioned by Vice President Joe Biden, and the general laughing as he says, "Are you asking about Vice President Biden? Who's that?" One of the general's aides is then quoted making a joke about the vice president. Comments made by the general's aides. Many of the most colorful quotes in the Rolling Stone article come from unnamed aides in the general's coterie. It is impossible to identify from the article how senior these anonymous figures are, or how close they are to the general. One unnamed advisor says General McChrystal was disappointed after his first meeting with President Barack Obama. Another unnamed aide dismisses General James Jones, the Obama administration's national security advisor, as a clown who is stuck in 1985.